Yes. Just looking at this big bailout that happened, yes, September of 2008, just 10 short years ago, the U.S. government took over two huge mortgage finance companies. When I think about suing those that are in office, those in law enforcement for the knowledge of the fraud, yes. I think that there are some federal government employees that have various amounts of liability for refusing to enforce the rights of the Constitution. Yeah. Now, yesterday I talked about civil liberties, and I'm going to talk some more about that. But right now I'm focused on exactly how did any bank know that the power went out? See, it was kind of odd. I was there and I was underneath the blankets and it was dark because there was no power. Yes. And I noticed that prisons have a backup system, don't they? Yes. Seemed like there was a lot of static electricity in the air when the power was out. Which, and then there's assistance. Yes. Could you call Homeland Security and get me every employee of Homeland Security since they started in 2003 because of the September 11th incident that we experienced here in the United States? Yes. Now, I know 3G was working because I updated, yeah, well, actually, I uploaded to my drive, yes, my countdown timer. I wanted to make sure that I didn't lose track of exactly what I was experiencing. Yes. And the thought that 3G was working, yes. And then the prison system, their power was on. And then every backup of every alarm system kicked on. Now, I'm looking through the alarm systems of the banks of Clallam County. Seemed like there was a lot of static and 3G. And oh, look at cell hearing. I'm going to go to court in 19 days, 22 hours, 43 minutes, and 5 4 seconds. Now, what I want to know, yes, is what kind of battery? And then how many satellites all of a sudden said, oh, we better watch what's going on. Now, this bailout of the United States federal government, yes, the amount of the AIG bailout exceeded $180 billion. And then there was a $700 billion bailout in large part to aid those in trouble financial industry. When you really start adding it up, it looks like $1 trillion or more, yes, was used in that whole situation. Now, could you get me the TARP funds and those that received the funds? Because it seemed like we spent $1 trillion because of a manufactured crisis. Yes. Where somebody said, well, we're going to issue these loans and we're going to cause a collapse of the economy. Then we're going to lower interest rates to 0%. Then we're just going to act like nothing happened. And then we're going to raise interest rates to 2.25%. And we're act like nothing going on. Now, my thought is that I have a large number of lawsuits that I'm wanting to file. Yes. For issuing a dissolution of marriage where the mail was returned unclaimed? Yes. And you gave custody of my son, see, Budnick, Budnek. You didn't grow up with my father like I didn't grow up with your father. What happened was my parents were divorced when I was approximately 8 years old. Yes. My mother, my biological mother that's going to prison? Yeah. Well, she met the next door neighbor when I was very young, and he had two daughters, Heather and Wendy. Yes. Well, while going through that divorce, she had her second, well, maybe she did cheat on him. I don't know that for sure. She might have had sex outside of marriage while being married to my father. She often claimed that he was having sex outside of marriage, but I don't know that for sure. Well, Douglas Taylor, yes, was living in an apartment next to the apartment that we were living in. Somehow they consummated a relationship, then they got divorced, and my mom moved us, myself and my sister, to Spokane, Washington. And I started school in Spokane in the third grade at Jefferson Elementary School. Yes, my sister, Susan Bowers, that's going to prison. Yes. She started kindergarten. Oh, there's a 2-year age difference between the two of us. She's, well, Our birthday's in December. Yes. The non-identical twins, Heather and Wendy, their birthday's in November. Well, growing up in Spokane, yes, I know I kind of got off track, but I thought it was important to just really focus in on Pooch. That stepfather, right, was the next door neighbor of ourselves when living in an apartment. Yes. Now, I know when mortgage rates were 12%, you remember that 87? Yes. There was some sort of financial crash. Yeah, I was 17 at that time. But you remember the 70s when we had hyperinflation? Yes. Volcker kept raising the interest rates up. He said, inflation's a concern, inflation's a concern. And it used to be that you could get a 10-year treasury bond for 10 to 11% in the late 70s in the United States of America. But today you'd be at, well, can you get a 3% treasury bond? Now, there seems to be a little problem with the whole concept of monetary supply. Now, these TARP funds, yes, I don't think you really appreciate where we're at as a nation. Now, I know, okay, that these funds, yes, why don't you get me all the employees of Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae and the approximate $700 billion bailout. Hank Paulson, how are you doing? We know that Neil Kashkari had the checkbook to the TARP funds. Yes, I just wanted to go. It's 10 years ago. Nobody knows. Just get me each and every individual and institution that received any of the finances from the Federal Reserve of the United States of America.